My name is Silje Munkvold and I work in the city of Bodø. As you can see, we're way up north, localized on the Arctic Circle, which in history made us geographically important military-wise. But in 2012, it was decided that we no longer would keep our fighter aircraft. So we needed to change our focus, but keep our significance. And in that way, we continue our fight of being this attractive city, which are still bringing something to the global scene. And as you can see from my picture, and probably have heard from stereotypical stories, it was important for us to tell more than just the story of Northern Lights and world-recognized salmon. We're really proud of that, but our ambitions is way bigger than the dot we make out on the map. So with high ambitions, transversal thinking, and a specific focus on how to elevate an integrated approach, the UN Sustainability Development Goals proved to be a very nice way to match as we wanted to develop our city to a new and sustainable showroom. Hence also my job title as Making a Better Day for our citizens is closely linked to making the first steps of creating a better world. So you can take the next slide, thank you. So our process of working together with a football team is closely linked to the changing roles of government in general, but also how the SDGs are calling for action from all stakeholders. So you can actually interpret this model in different kind of ways. Number one being that there's a lot of initiatives going on all over the place, but the solutions are often limited to the given stakeholders' character. Which in public sector is closely linked to having different silos in which is hard to break through. But in the service point of view, we are opening up for more measurements and making sure that we can actually read the results and making common target areas and so forth. And I think that is an important thing to bring to the table, which is why we have done an analysis from United for Smart Sustainable Cities with common KPIs that we can show to other cities in the world. But you can't really expect one actor to be involved in everything or that's going on or be able to manage and determine what success will look like, especially when it comes to the SDGs, which is open for multiple and actually contradictory goals and emergent solutions that are neither true or false, but rather maybe good or bad. However, I think being a public organization, it's easier for us to initiate the co-creation part because we kind of have the right authority and legitimacy to initiate this because we're positioned and perceived as guardians of the public interest. But when we're walking over to look at that tree model, it's super important because we need different projects and initiatives to keep growing on their own terms and rhythm, but to being able to actually connect and reach out to each other as we are going at our own pace is really important when we're trying to figure out this common narrative of engagement. And when you now have a football club in the middle, we're actually able to making a picture of how it's all connected so that you're in a feeling of it's I am a part of that change and it's my city that is winning on my contribution and it's together we're actually making each other responsible for the results. So for the next picture. So that's kind of why we started this collaboration. And I think when you look at this slide, the pictures to the right is pretty much our vision. What are we going to fill our city with? What is the potential? But the picture to the left is our action. Because if we're getting really technical, the city pictures are just buildings, right? The new city that we're building after the fighter planes are gone and needs content. And to make content, we need the emotions, we need the conscience, and we need the new kinds of relations that are being built by having a common goal that's able to approach by multi-level means, which means it could be as easy to just acquire knowledge being a seven-year-old going to match day or actually being the stakeholder that are making new solutions and sharing them. So a football team comes in as such a neutral actor, disregarding the fact that you most likely either hate or love it, But from a grand message point of view, it's so powerful because you can actually compare the action to how they're doing in the competition. You see the action and you feel it and you know it's happening in one way or the other just because it's so visual. It's right there on the jersey, it's in the attendance of the stadium, it's in the statistics of how they're actually using their different strategies. And obviously it's just buzzing in society because it's connected to this team that that's either beloved or hated. So I think there's a really nice way of comparing how you are interested in a football team to how you're interested in development, because there are different ways of feeling engaged and there are a lot of different possibilities to how to actually take action and be part of something bigger. So that is absolutely our biggest gain from working with Bodø Glimt as this glue that sticks us all together. And my time is up, but I would just say that the most important thing is to get your top leaders in on it from the beginning, because this is gonna be a success and it will get there even faster if you have the right people from the start. But one way or the other, it's gonna end up with them being interesting when they can see all these goals that are being met. So thank you for the time.